Welcome back to Wellness Wednesday with Mr. Brown of Beacon Hill. Today we have a goodie. We have Rise Up, Extraordinary Kids with Extraordinary Stories by Amanda Lee, illustrated by Amy Blackwell. Today we will explore the fabulous feats of Pele. First story, can't wait. The Fabulous Feats of Pele, Brazil. A young boy ran around a corner of a dusty Brazilian street, kicking what looked like a ball with his bare feet. It actually was an old sock stuffed with newspaper tied with a string. But even without a proper soccer ball, anyone could see he had talent. He could do all sorts of skillful tricks, bouncing his ball from knee to knee, on his head and back. He had an obvious passion for the game. The boy's name was Edson Arantes do Nascimento, but his friends nicknamed him Pele. Though he was poor and from a deprived neighborhood in his small town of Brazil, this boy would grow up to become one of the best soccer players, many will say the best soccer player in the world, the legendary Pele. Pele was from Brazil, a country that adores soccer. The day he was playing in the streets, Sunday, July 16, 1950, was a day of a very important match. All of Brazil thought their team, the best in the world, was going to beat Uruguay in the FIFA World Cup in the famous stadium. Everyone stopped working to watch the match. It was huge. But then, the unthinkable happened. The score was 1-1, but with 10 minutes to go, Uruguay scored a second goal. Brazil had lost. Everyone was stunned. Men and women wept in the streets. Pele's father was in tears. Pele was 9 years old, and he was devastated. So he made a vow that he would never forget. One day, he promised his father, "One day I will win the World Cup." And that's exactly what he did. At 11 years old, Pele began playing for his first soccer team. He was so good at 15, he was taken on as a player by Santos, a well-known Brazilian soccer club. By the time he was 17, Pele had been selected to play for Brazil in the 1958 World Cup. An incredible achievement. This was his big chance to keep his promise. Pele's first goal of the tournament was sensational. It was in Brazil's quarterfinal win over Wales. He had become the youngest player ever to score a goal in the World Cup. He followed up with a hat trick in a semifinal against France. Brazil was now in the final. Pele didn't disappoint the cheering crowds. He scored two spectacular goals against Sweden in the final whistle, the score was 5-Brazil, Sweden 2. Brazil was the winner. This was the second cup to be televised, and Pele had showed off his incredible talent to the world. People were talking about him everywhere. He done it. Pele went on to win two more World Cups and scored an incredible 1,281 goals during his career. His ball control, dribbling and heading skills were ahead of his time. He was famous for his bicycle kick, an acrobatic move in which his back to the goal, he would jump in the air and kick the ball over his head into the goal. No wonder that in 2000, Pele was named Joint FIFA Player of the Century and Athlete of the Century by the International Olympic Committee. Now that we finished the book, we have an activity for you to do. How to juggle. Basically, you're going to bounce a soccer ball from knee to knee. It can be a soccer ball. It can be any type of ball. We want you to bounce it from knee to knee, and we want you to upload your video to Beacon Hill Facebook page or Instagram page. Can't wait to see it.